Hello everyone, this is financial author Ahmed Dunn of AhmedDunn.com. On this channel, you'll find financial, travel, and more videos just like the one you're watching right now. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Hello everyone, this is financial author Ahmed Dunn of AhmedDunn.com. Today, I'll talk about manufactured spending and CIBC Air Canada AC Conversion Visa prepaid card that has recently taken steps to seal manufactured spending loophole. For those of you who do not know what is manufactured spending is a spending that is not real spending or that is manufactured, which would create spendings to generate points or reward points. And there are various ways of doing that, which I'll not go into detail today. However, one of the easiest ways to generate manufactured spending in Canada was the CIBC Air Canada AC Conversion Visa prepaid card, which let you load Canadian currency, and then you were able to withdraw Canadian dollars from CIBC ATM machines, and that would create a manufactured spending from the credit card, because the CIBC Air Canada credit card allowing to load from other credit cards. So that type of transactions would create manufacturer spendings on the other credit cards to generate points. Now in the past, the initial limit per day to load a CIBC Air Canada card was $3,000 in the beginning. Then once they found out that a lot of people are taking advantage of the manufacturer spending loophole, then they lowered down the daily limit to $2,000 per day, which is still fantastic. And then after that, once they found out that they couldn't cope up with the all these manufacturer spendings, in order to tighten the rules, they lowered it to $100 per day. So what it means that you are loading $100 Canadian per day, and then you are withdrawing the Canadian dollar amount from CIBC bank machines, so you're able to do $700 per week, which is approximately $3,000 per month. And in terms of annual spending, it would create about $35,000-$36,000 per year, which is still not bad, because if you're doing $35,000 per year, and if you do it for 2 years, then you have enough points to for a business class flight going to Asia, which would be $5,000 in value. So that was like a heaven for travel hackers who are using the CIBC Air Canada card to create manufacturer spendings. So the way it worked was CIBC Air Canada, for this credit card, you're able to load, I believe, 10 foreign currencies, including Canadian dollars. And then if you're in Canada, you can withdraw Canadian dollar from CIBC bank machines without any cost. So it would be a manufacturer's spending heaven to load $100 every month, I'm sorry, every day, and then take out $700 per week. So you can do it in in two times or three times every week, because CIBC machines, I noticed that they have a limit of $400 per transaction, each transaction whenever you're redeeming Canadian dollars. So now that CIBC Air Canada found out that they still cannot go ahead with $100 Canadian per day limit, because they were bleeding money paying credit card fees to other credit cards from which travel hackers were loading the CIBC Air Canada credit card. So they made a new announcement that starting April 13th, they will stop totally loading Canadian dollars onto the card, and you will not be able to withdraw Canadian currency from an ATM machine or from a CIBC ATM machine. So what it means that there's no more manufacturer spending using this card from March 13th. And if you wanted to load a foreign currency, for example US dollars or Australian dollars or other eligible foreign currency CIBC Air Canada allows you to load, and then you try to redeem Canadian dollars from a CIBC bank machine in Canada,
then that machine actually will not dispense Canadian dollars bills. Instead, it will dispense US dollar bills. So what it means that you're paying foreign currency transaction cost or transaction fee twice. Once you load foreign dollar onto the card, and then once you take out US dollars. So this is not going to be working anymore, or this didn't make sense, paying almost 5% for each transaction to create manufactured spending. So as a result, the loophole has been sealed, or which will not be effective, available after April, and then there will not be, you'll not be able to do this anymore. I heard that in the beginning, people were loading and taking out or withdrawing Canadian money like insane from this trade card. And there are many people who became points millionaires just by, you know, using the loophole existed in the CIBC Air Canada AC Conversion Prepaid trade card. So now it took them for a while to find out what's going on and close the loop at the end. But in between, lots of people became point millionaires just using this credit card. There are other ways to do manufactured spending in Canada, but we have very limited opportunities comparing to the US, where there are more opportunities exist for manufactured spending. But in Canada, CIBC Air Canada credit card was one of the easiest ways to create manufacturer spending, but it's all gone for now. So this is an update I wanted to provide you. Please let me know if you have used this credit card, or if you have done manufactured spending using the CIBC AC Canada Conversion Visa credit card. And this credit card will exist, however, you will be able to load only foreign currency. And once you have leftover foreign currency and you return to Canada, then you can withdraw that US dollar bills using an ATM machine. So this is not, you know, it's not going to make sense, or it's not going to be applicable to do manufactured spending anymore. So I do have a review of the CIBC Air Canada credit card, which I have done in the past. I'll provide you a link or links down below. And I have another credit card reviews. So thank you for watching. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing, and there will be more videos coming up. Thank you.